Witajcie w kolejnym odcinku Ace Combat. Moi drodzy, mamy Mirage. No, wybieram Mirage oczywiście, którą dzisiaj wybierzemy sobie. To weźmiemy sobie. I Select Parts. My zrobimy sobie tak. I ruszajmy na misję, moi drodzy. Pierwszy kontakt, moi drodzy, tak się ta misja nazywa. Zobaczmy, co ma dla nas do zaoferowania.
Spare squadron, this mission needs to be quick. Target radar facilities and AA weaponry. They're set up on a rugged terrain, and there's a lot of cloud cover. You will be near thunderclouds. Man, you guys were born unlucky.
Wait, who's the dumbass who came up with this batshit plan?
Just obey orders.
Air Force Base 444 Squadron, Cyclops 1.
Tej misji musimy być szybcy, tak wyraźnie. Udało się, kurczę, się nie udało. Aj, fuck. Dobra, zniszczony oczywiście. Mamy Aguna, dobra. My to ktoś tutaj, kurczę, wali, jest od tyłu. Znaczy wali, próbuje walić, nie? No jeszcze tego musimy oczywiście załatwić, którego nie załatwił. Dobra, załatwione. Niezbyt cenny, ale ważne, że...
Use missiles!
Przecież powoli się rakiety kończą. Dobra, wszystkie zniszczone. Śmiesznie teraz ta burza wygląda, co te błyskawice. Lepsza od Just Cause'a najnowszego. No to jest zburzenie nitro po powietrzu. No. Gdyby było powietrze, to zdecydowanie byłoby to lepszy niż w Just Cause 4. Back trigger. Oh shit. Ale dostaliśmy go czwarcie, wszystko mryga. Uuu, nie mamy na radarze. O, już mamy. I się takie zakłócenia specjalne zrobiłem, jest, nie? No i teraz ktoś we mnie celuje niby. Zniszczyliśmy gnoje. Kurcz.
Looks like there's one guy who's got everyone's backs.
Ej, kurczę, nie trafiliśmy. To za amunicją nasz już słabo, moi drodzy. Jeszcze jedna tam wersja z tym. Wiecie, w jednej wersji już nie mamy tych rakiet, mamy tylko te na razie, takie podwójne. Dobra. Kurczę, tych naszych wrogów nie walnie żadne ten. Aj, znowu nazwane. Czemu w tamtych nie wali, co? Tylko musi to być w nasz samolot. Jak ładnie, załatwiony bez, w ogóle bez radaru żadnego. I zaraz chyba wracamy, co? Co teraz? Coś się stanie? Kurczę, flaru żył, czy co? No dobrze, misja zakończona w tym momencie. Jest. I teraz jakieś kastanki czy inne stanki. I don't screw up, I just... Dobra, wolniej musimy. Teraz wystarczy wylądować i koniec misji, moi drodzy. Tak będzie, tak jest. Dobra. Takie śmieszne linie jest. Już nie wiem nigdy, co latem nie latałem, tak szczerze.
Said the enemy had one mean son of a bitch flying for him. Our team had a few Air Force hot dogs, real experienced pilots. But this guy swooped in like a hawk, locked on, and took them all out in the blink of an eye. Reminds me of a story Gramps told me once. He said a little while before he retired from active duty, he saw an enemy fighter wipe out an entire formation right in front of him. It was like seeing how a shark works when it's going after its dinner. This enemy pilot stalked Gramps' pals from below, just like how a shark would. Then one by one, he put the bite on them. Sounds like what happened to our guys today. Kinda surprised so many made it back alive. I bet when they saw what was going on, they broke formation and left their buddies to the shark. Hang on. There's three extra planes here. They're foreigners too.
Spare squadron, this mission needs to be quick. Target radar.
chance to talk to one of the pilots that escaped back here, so I took it. Apparently, two of our planes took the enemy on alone. They covered the Allies so they could retreat. The hell kind of idiot does a thing like that? The last pilot to land back at the base was that scrawny anarchist dude. He always had this dumb grin on his face, like he didn't give a damn about whatever he did to get thrown in here with the rest of us. Was he the one who went gung-ho? I bought him a drink later. After the usual small talk, I turned the topic around to the mission. For an anarchist, he struck me as a bit weird. Nothing like what I expected. He talked a mile a minute and kept going on and on about library books. Not encyclopedias, those cheesy adventure novels you read in high school. Nothing against those. I like a good story myself once in a while. But I wasn't here to talk books.
I remember that day well. Amidst the swirling clouds, the fighter squadron was trying to help its allies reach safety.
He's pretty foolish, isn't he?
I thought so too. Suddenly, a highly skilled enemy fighter squadron appeared and began picking them off at the edges. One by one, they fell right out of the sky.
Although, I guess there was nobody around that was even more foolish to go to their aid then. So you simply watch things unfold from a distance.
Yeah. I mean, who would have ever thought that I'd just go and follow them straight into the enemy squadron like that?
After what felt like decades, I finally got to the info I was looking for. He wasn't the guy. He said he was just following his wingman's lead and managed not to die somehow. The hero on this mission was the new guy, the one that killed Harling. How did you feel?
I'm still kind of shaken up, actually. But you know, I do feel a certain sense of pride, too.
He really is foolish, isn't he?
Yep, he sure is.
I went to the hangar to have myself a closer look at Trigger's plane. I knew that burnt smell. That's what happens when an engine's been driven to its limit. This pilot was a hot dog. From now on, I was gonna keep my eye on this idiot. From a distance, though. I didn't want to get too tight with someone who was a better pilot than my dad. Even so, I decided to give this guy's plane a little bit of the old Avril magic touch. He needed all the help he could get.
From one fight on to the next, two outlaws ride with weapons flexed. One is quick, the other's tall. Together they'll kill them all.